Hi, welcome back to the garage. In today's episode, I'll be taking some port casts with Vinamold. We're producing a port map, and additionally, we're going to be measuring all the timing in this cylinder, inputting it into Dat2T, and then assessing how much power this cylinder can produce for the port areas it's got, and I get some more parts. So, if you're liking so far and you're liking the series and you're intrigued to see how it goes, then please like and subscribe and continue to watch as I progress to try and get to 100 mile an hour. And also, if you've got any points or questions or anything, please leave them in the comments and I'll get back to you. Thanks. So, chopped up in a cup. I'm going to give it 30 seconds. Yeah. Nowhere near. Another 30. As you can see, nice and fluid now, we'll go pour this into the transfer ports. Right, I'm just going to do one at a time, so we're going to do that one. I'm going to use the piston to actually seal the hole so I can get it in. Right, it's had about sort of 5 minutes, so hopefully I should be able to get this piston out. Pull this in this way. Coming out okay, and if you can see down there, it's in there. So now it's just a case of getting your finger in and working it. And I'll pull at the top, just try and pull it a little bit. And you can see it's got like a release agent on it, anyway. And then just start to come out, and that's it. So there you go, they are the ports. And as I say, they are very nicely done. Not ideal. Ideally, you want a big sweep like an RSA, but this is quite an old cylinder design, so it's got old style transfer ports. However, from what I can see, they look quite good. So, onto the exhaust port. There we go. So that's a cast of the port. That's your window again. Looks fairly good. It's just this bit here I'm not happy about. I can really see me making an insert to possibly restrict this outlet a little bit more, make it a little bit narrower and get rid of this. I don't really like, I don't think that's gonna be good for flow. I want that to be more like that. But that's a job for another video. So that's the exhaust. And last but not least, the inlet. Go the inlet, obviously a bit of a boost there, and then you've got the piston controlled inlet port there, and hopefully it'll be wider than that so we can get a V-Force 3 reading. I'll be interested to see the dyno comparisons of the standard, the modified and the V-Force 3, but that's going to be in quite a few videos time, I think. And there you go. Put tape on there. Put on there. Now you can see the angles that the transfer ports are flowing in. And the other thing I'll just point out, this exhaust port, as you can see, it isn't straight, it bends. So another idea is to maybe try and straighten it out a little bit. Whether I'm going to have enough material here to do it, I don't know. However, we'll see. See how desperate for power we get. Right, I'll attempt to do a port map now. Cut a piece of paper. Put it in there. Try and get it nice and
tall and tight. Right, this is the setup I'm using to measure the port timing a bit more accurate. There's a guy, Two-Stroke Stuffing, he did quite a good video on this. It was a very good video. I've nicked his method. I'll leave a link in the description to the actual video of the setup. But basically, there's a DTI. It's zeroed at bottom dead center, which is effectively the bottom of the port. And then as you turn it round, unfortunately this one's empirical. That's 200/300 thou, and then as we're getting up, I've got this piece of welding rod. It's 1.6 mil diameter, but at a 45 degree angle, using trigonometry, the distance across the flats there, parallel to this bit, is 2.26 mil. So it's what you can use it for. You can use it for using, because it's a reference. There's only 2 points because it's round. You can then put it into the port, hold it square to the cylinder, and then as you go up, that's it. That's 345 thou. 346 I got before. I converted that to 8.79 mil, and then added on that thickness of 2.26, which told me that the and then took that away from the stroke, which is 41.6. Mail time. Coil, and this should be 1000 watts and an Ignitech fully programmable CDI.
Right, this is Dat2T, developed by Vanik Developments. Niels van Niekerk. It's basically the preprocessor, so this is where you input all your data before it goes through the simulator program itself, EngMod 2T, and then once it's processed that data, you can then view it in post 2T. So I've input everything in. No, I do say it's BDK. I'm sure the guy said it was a BDK tune. However, if anyone reckons it's not, please let me know. Right, so this is where I put in all the information that I've measured. So you've got the basic engine. You've got the basic engine configuration here, all inputted. And then I put the exhaust port in. So you can see that's the exhaust port I've modelled. Effective port diameter 29 mil. Something to note. Transfers again I've done. So you can display that windows only. You can see them all fairly level, although they are quite high duration, quite a lot of area as well, more than an exhaust. I think it's too much transfer, not enough exhaust, particularly blow down area. My little mold, Vinamold, I made with all the input angles. I used that, drew on a piece of paper, and came up with this. This is the information, and this gave me the correct flow width of the port, which was actually quite similar to what I measured with a set of calipers. So however, it's all verified and checked, so I'm happy with that. And those were the widths I came up with, or the program came up with. Other things, I put the inlet in, exhaust, if anyone's interested in the dimensions, I'll pop them up there. Looks fairly good. I can't see anything massively wrong with it. We'll soon find out when we test it, and then we can look to refine it. And again, I put the carb in. Ignition wise, I just used the BDK curve. But the main bit I'm interested in is specific time area. So I've gone for 11,000 RPM. It's peak and 11.9 bar. However, that should give me 28.5 horsepower, which is probably going to be about 22.5, 23 horsepower at the rear wheel. Hopefully that will be enough. However, having measured everything up, you can see main port STA. It gives you, it can sustain that port 19.5 horsepower. And bear in mind, this is at the crank, so roughly 15% losses to the rear wheel. So, however, that's really irrelevant. The main one you're looking at is blowdown, and this really determines the power output of the whole engine. Get this right, everything else should fall into place. And it's only 18.3, so maybe 15 horsepower, 14, 15 horsepower at the rear wheel. That's what I kind of expect. We'll see what happens when I get around to dynoing it. And as you can see, that is 29.8 effective diameter of the port, whereas the transfers are more 31.3. And also note, they should be able to support 37 horsepower. So I need to borrow some of this transfer area and increase my blowdown area. So that is where I want, and then I'll fill up on whatever transfer area I can get after. The main worrying bit is the reed block, effective diameter 20, 25 for cache, quite a bit less than the exhaust and transfers, which is why it's saying you probably get about 12 horsepower if you're lucky out of that. So V-Force 3 reed block, I'll try and get a bigger one as possible, probably the KX65. However, I'm open to other ideas if anyone's got any. The reed petal opening, I'm not too fussed about that, will tend to sort itself out. The other worry I got is this 22.5 mil effective diameter for the inlets in the skirt, for the inlet port. That's not enough, that needs to be more, so I need to address that. Yeah, it's saying you want 37, it recommends. And for a carb diameter, 29 mil. So quite a lot of scope to improve, hopefully. However, we're going to do the first dyno run once I've got it all together with a base curve in, and see where we can go for there, see what the power is, and then I'm going to basically look at reducing the transfers, increasing the blowdown area, and trying to put a bigger reed valve in, with bigger ports in the reed valve block to give me more area there, and also the transfer, the inlet area as well. I need to increase that, and I think I need a bigger than 21 mil diameter carb, but we'll get to that. So that's the base, that's what we got, that's what we're going to test, and then we're going to look at incremental improvements, find the area, find a restriction, remove that restriction, find the next restriction, remove that restriction, and continue until hopefully got enough horsepower to gets to 100 mile an hour. So I'll leave it there for a minute, and catch you all later.
Okay, thanks so much for watching today. Hope that was of some use, or people got something out of it. Again, if you've got any questions, any points, any tips, please let me know. Next time I'm going to look to get the engine together, get it in back in the bike, and then I can look to take it to dyno and probably look to get it MOT'd as well, so I can use it on the road. So yeah, that's probably going to be next time. So if you're interested, please like, please subscribe, please share, and I'll be back with you in a couple of weeks with more of an update. Thank you.